come across somebody once in a while you shouldn't have messed with. That's me. Well, I
won't back down. I am not an African American.
You're Oreo cookie, white in the inside and black on the outside.
I don't have an Afro. I have an Amerifro.
Talking that idiotic stuff you talk about, I will slap you.
Go ahead, make my day.
Black at the Ace of Spades, but 100% American.
Heard around the world by everybody and their mama. The Jesse Lee Peterson Radio Show.
Uniting the races with truth instead of dividing them with lies. We're also rebuilding the family by rebuilding the man. I am Jesse Lee Peterson. Good morning. Welcome back from Happy Thanksgiving weekend. It was a long weekend. I know some people are still traveling. I hope you all had a happy Thanksgiving. And if you had some encounters with your liberal friends and family members, I like to hear those stories. I would like to hear about them. You can get involved by calling 888-775-3773, 888-77-JESSE. My Thanksgiving was excellent, quiet-like. Caught up with some work that I needed to catch up with, but nice and quiet, spent some time with family, but got a lot of other things done, so it was excellent. And it's good to be back to work. It's good to be back to work. We have been telling you about this. It's fine, Joe. We have been telling you about this wildfire down in out here in California. Out here in California. And it was a horrible situation. I'm glad to report to you that the fire has been contained. Yahoo News and Reuters is reporting that California's deadliest wildfire has finally been contained. At least 85 people were killed. That's a sad commentary. 85 people were killed. 249 were missing as of Sunday. 249 people were missing. It's sad, folks. Really, really bad. It was an awful fire. And Sacramento Bee is reporting the devastation of this fire. We have a B-roll there. This is from Sacramento Bee. We have a B-roll of the devastation left in Paradise, California. That's what you're looking at right now. And it was up in Northern California area. And it was a bad situation. Thank God that the rain came. It rained, I believe it was Wednesday night of last week, or maybe even Thanksgiving night. And because of the rain, they were able to really, the rain put it out. And so now they are searching through the aftermath for bodies to see if there are others that they can find. Hopefully those people just fled and they are going to, you know, report in later. Hope so. Bad situation. You know, we just had Thanksgiving and a lot of people go shopping and they're trying to get the sales and things that happened. There was something called Black Friday. And Black Friday was not good in many places. I'm always surprised when I see people fighting over TVs and clothes and just really carrying on about these things. WGN TV is reporting, and I don't know where this is from, what city, state, or town, but oh, this is Tennessee, I've been told. So WGN TV. A hoodie that was for sale sparked Black Friday chaos at a Victoria's Secret in Tennessee. And so what happened was, folks, this hoodie, no, not the one that Michael Brown had on. This hoodie was $79, the regular price, and they marked this hoodie down to $35. And as a result of that, the people went wild. This is from WGN9, footage of the crowd rushing the store table The woman on the table there, I believe she's the sales lady. Amazing. Also, the store worker sit on the table and shout, "Are you serious? Are you serious? Why are the men doing it? This is at Victoria's Secret. I think that's a woman's store. Unless they're there for their wives or girlfriends or something. That's amazing. Talking about not putting God first, huh? They're putting material things before what's right. This is amazing. But this is what we have in our country today. This is what passion looked like. This is their passion to get a hoodie for Victoria's Secret. That's amazing, folks. I wonder when these people see themselves in the news acting this way, is there a sense of shame about it? Do they regret doing this? We also have coming up for you the border situation. It was bad, folks. The illegal alien mob tried to rush the borders in California, down by the San Diego area there. And we have that coming up for you as well. We need to take our country back. We need to restore values and principles. And the only way that's going to happen, we got to restore families. Because you get your first start in your family. And if your father and mother are not setting a good example, are not perfect parents, They set you up for things like this. We got to restore families. The children of the lie, they want this chaos. They want confusion. They want destruction because it helps them at the voting booth. There was a shooting down in, I don't know where this was either. Sorry about that. According to the Huffington Post, there was multiple shooting at a mall. Oh, there were multiple shootings at malls around the country, so it's not one location. One black man was killed by police who believed he was the suspect in the shooting of two teenagers. But now they believe he wasn't the one who fired the shots. And when I first heard about this story, I have to tell you, the first thing that came to my mind is that the black race hustlers, the liberal white race hustlers, the ones who use black people for personal gain, will start using this as a race issue between blacks and cops. And believe you me, I wasn't wrong about it. It's so typical. It's so typical. Whenever there is a black involved in police shooting, the blacks are so brainwashed and dumbed down and demoralized, they automatically go into the race issue. It's sad, but true. ABC News report on police shooting of a black man.
protests in Alabama over a shooting at a mall on Thanksgiving night. Police now admit that the 21-year-old who they shot and killed was likely not the gunman.
ABC's Lindsay Davis joins us now with what his grieving parents are saying about their son being shot and then apparently wrongly identified as the suspect.
The family of 21-year-old Emantic Bradford Jr. is calling his death on Thanksgiving an assassination. Their attorney says that the Hoover police jumped to conclusions by assuming that Bradford was a criminal simply because he was a black man with a gun. And police say the real gunman is still at large.
So black people carrying on at a mall shooting, these are young blacks shooting, which is typical of blacks. And the police steps in. One black man get killed by the cops because they thought he was the shooter. He had a gun. They thought he was the shooter. And this is an assassination. This is a joke, an absolute joke. It really is. And these people are already protesting. They're not protesting out of control abortion in the black community. No protest. Everybody and their mama are having abortions. 70% of Planned Parenthood abortion mills are located in the inner cities. No protest. Not from the blacks. They're not protesting black on black violence out of control in most of the urban areas around the country. No protest. But let a white cop or let a cop kill a black man, especially if he's white, is an assassination. And somehow or another, they come up with a protest overnight. Black Americans, not all, but your values are misplaced. Here's the man's mother. Do we have time for that? When I come back, I want you to hear what his mother has to say, the father, and the stupid protesters crying, racist police. You cannot have pity for black people. You got to tell them the truth, folks. They're out of control. They're not using their brains at all. Back in a moment. It's not unusual to see me cry. I want to die. It's not unusual to go out at any time. But when I see you out and about, it's such a crime. If you should ever want to be loved by anyone, it's not unusual, it happens every day. No matter what you say.
With an SRN News Business Brief, I'm George Bonzani. The National Retail Federation is projecting holiday retail sales to increase by nearly 5% this year over last year's totals, with much of that coming from online shopping. Early indications are that in-store pickup of merchandise that was ordered online doubled last Wednesday and Thursday. John Copeland is with Adobe Analytics, who tracks those stats, saying that Black Friday and Cyber Monday are shaping up to be record breakers this year.
For the entire season, we're expecting about $124 billion in online sales, and that represents nearly a 15% growth rate.
Meanwhile, overseas, Britain and the European Union reached an agreement to govern the UK's departure from the EU, dubbed Brexit. The 27 EU leaders met in Brussels to endorse the withdrawal agreement and political declaration. With SRN Business, I'm George Bonzani.
Check out my nonprofit website, rebuildingtheman.com. We need your financial support. Matter of fact, we got to get a brand new building, the one we're leasing. They're going to tear it down and turn it into an apartment building. You know, that's how life is. So hopefully we can buy a building. We need your support. We need your donation. Been around 27 years, not one dime from the government. And for those who have given and have already given, been given forever and a day, thank you so much, folks. Go to rebuildingtheman.com or call 800-411-2663. And all donations are tax deductible, all right? So you do get your money back, too. If you need counseling, we provide counseling for people around the world, men, women, and children. We have, like, amazing counseling. You may not need but one session, two at best. It's so amazing. evil, right versus wrong. No such thing as racism, sexism, homophobiaism, Islamophobiaism, or deadbeat-dad-ism. It's all made up. It's a lie, and I got proof. Down in Alabama, I remember growing up in Alabama on a plantation. Alabama was a nice place to live, to raise decent children. Black Americans had a sense of morality and what was right. Their kids wouldn't know how to respect others when they're out and about. But now, due to the destruction of the family, that's disappearing in Alabama as well. When I was growing up, I never heard of people shooting and killing when you go shopping. It's crazy. And then blaming the cop for it. So I mentioned just before the break from the Huffington Post, there were multiple shootings at a mall around the country. And down in Alabama, one black man was killed by police who believed he was the suspect in the shooting of two teenagers. But now they believe he wasn't the one who fired the shot. He did have a gun, by the way. And rather than decent people waiting to gather all the information and do it the right way, the hustlers, race hustlers, the power seekers are once again crying racism. They are calling this an assassination. And I'm sure most Americans are just shaking their heads at this. It's like when you hear racism, sexism, and all this crap that the liberals are throwing at us, it gets to a point where you don't believe it anymore. You just shake your head because they're using it for personal gain. So here is the mother of the man that was shot and killed down in Alabama there at this mall.
An impassioned plea from a mother just days after her son was gunned down in an Alabama mall on Thanksgiving.
It feels like someone has ripped my heart out. My heart hurts for my child.
A tragic end to a chaotic night where two others were shot, including a 12-year-old girl. April Pipkins and Amantic Bradford Sr. are demanding answers after police announced an unlikely suspect in the shootings, their son, 21-year-old Amantic Fitzgerald Bradford Jr., known as EJ.
So I understand that the parents want to know what happened. Any parent would want to know what happened, right? But decent parents would wait. If you need to get an attorney, get an attorney, do an investigation, and get the issue resolved. Why do you have to go stupid like this? Why do you have to cry racism and an assassination? Here's the man's father. Here's what he had to say about it.
They just went to rush the judgment on national TV and slandered my son's name. Got my son looking like he a killer.
After videos surfaced of people running and ducking from gunfire, police issued a statement saying Bradford Jr. was the shooter. Less than 24 hours later, police retracted that statement. In a press release, Hoover police saying new evidence now suggests that while Mr. Bradford may have been involved in some aspect of the altercation, he likely did not fire the rounds that injured the 18-year-old victim.
So the cops came out and said, we got the shooter. We know who did it. And with further investigation, they come right back and say, hey, no, we might have the wrong guy. Is this father happy about that, that the cops came back and held a press conference saying, no, it might be the wrong guy? Does he appreciate that? The cops are damned if they do and damned if they don't when it comes to the black folks. This is all an act, by the way. It's not real. Because if black people cared about violence, don't you think, or do you think, that they would be out protesting the black-on-black violence? They would be out protesting abortion. they would be out protesting the corrupt black so-called leaders that they vote for year in and year out. There are protesters crying. This is so silly, I almost hate to report it to you. It's so typical. There are protesters crying racist police.
Bradford, who briefly trained with the Army, died hours after his mother saw him that Thanksgiving morning. She says she found out about his death on social media.
That is no way to learn of your child's death. That's not fair. That's not humane.
Police say Bradford was carrying a gun when the shooting broke out, but protesters who came out in support of Bradford say it's about more than the gun.
A black life taken away. A black man literally gave his life for this country, for them to take it away from it.
So how about the fact that this man went to a mall where a bunch of black people were, and he was killed as a result of the shooting that happened, because whenever most black people get together, this is what happens? How about that? If this black man had not gone to that mall, and had gone to a mall where there were a few blacks, he'd probably be alive today, because we wouldn't have had the shootout. No one's talking about that. What happened to black people that they lost all sense of values, that now whenever you go to a gathering where there are mostly blacks, especially young blacks, you got to have this type of outcome? But no, it's easier to blame the cops rather than taking responsibility for themselves. Some witnesses claim he was trying to protect people from the gunman.
We definitely will get justice for our child. So no other parent should have to go through this.
An attorney for the family says that Bradford was licensed to carry a concealed firearm. His parents will hold a press conference later this morning with their attorney to demand that police release videos of the incident. They say that witnesses have come forward saying Bradford was actually trying to wave people away from the shooter. They believe that the video will confirm this. So many things that are disconcerting about this, but finding out that your son was killed on social media.
It's just too much. It's awful.
Beta male. So what's pathetic about this is that this woman said, the mother said, oh, just awful. I had to find it out on social media. It's just not right. It's just not right. It ain't right. Social media is everywhere now. That's how you find out any information nowadays, for the most part. Everywhere people go, you could be on an elevator. They got to have their cameras ready. So who are you blaming for that, lady? The families, listen to this. This says it all, really. I rest my case. The family's lawyer is Benjamin Crump. And as you all know, and if not, I would inform you and or remind you, Benjamin Crump was a lawyer who represented the family of Trayvon Martin in Florida, the thug that was killed by Joyce Zimmerman. Benjamin Crump represented the family of Trayvon Martin in Florida and Micah Brown in Ferguson, Missouri. I rest my case. Can we say race hustler? Can we say Justin Jackson, Louis Farrakhan, Al Sharpton? The same old game, folks. Blacks are being used.
I'm Wally Hines in Washington. A wintry storm with blizzard-like conditions continues to batter much of the central Midwest this morning, grounding hundreds of flights and closing major highways. Up to a foot of snow expected in Chicago, along with wind gusts up to 50 miles an hour. The governor in Kansas has declared a state of emergency.
U.S. border agents fired tear gas into a group of migrants attempting to violently breach the border near Tijuana yesterday. 39 people arrested. Mexico says it will deport those involved. President Trump hits the campaign trail again today. Mr. Trump will travel to Mississippi to give a boost to the Senate campaign of Cindy Hyde-Smith in her battle against former Agriculture Secretary Mike Espy. The U.N. is urging restraint after the Russian Coast Guard fired on Ukrainian naval vessels, injuring six. Ukraine says the incident happened in international waters. More details at srnnews.com.
I'm Jay Farner, CEO of Quicken Loans, America's premier home purchase lender. Today's fluctuating interest rates can leave you with unexpected higher mortgage payments. At Quicken Loans, we've created a new way to protect you from unpredictable interest rates so you can buy a home with certainty. It's called Rate Shield, and here's how it works. With Rate Shield, you can lock your interest rate while you shop for a new home. So if rates go up, you don't have to worry. And here's the best part. If rates go down, you get the lower rate. With Rate Shield, we really have you covered. Here are more reasons why you'll want to work with America's largest mortgage lender. For 8 years in a row now, J.D. Power has ranked Quicken Loans highest in the nation in customer satisfaction for primary mortgage origination. And for the fifth year in a row, they've also ranked us highest in the nation for mortgage servicing. Rate Shield, another way we can save you money on your mortgage. Call us today at 800-QUICKEN or go to rocketmortgage.com.
Based on Rocket Mortgage data in comparison to public data records, Rate Shield approval only valid on certain 30-year purchase transactions. Call for cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender license in all 50 states. NMLS number 3030. Additional conditions or exclusions may apply.
I'm not a doctor, but the one thing I can absolutely promise you, medication is not going to help you overcome bipolar or any other type of depression. It's only going to allow you to dig a deeper hole into hell. It's a spiritual problem that you have. It's not a physical thing. And if you want to overcome depression, suicidal thoughts, loneliness, emptiness, fear, doubt, and worry, if you want to find that perfect peace, there's only one solution. One only, folks. Don't let these experts tell you, oh, you need medication. Because when you take this medication, it's going to dumb you down to life. You're not going to be able to deal with the issues of life. There's only one solution to overcoming all this stuff. Drop your anger. How was your weekend? Joel is my audio engineer and the owner of Gifted Dancers or something. What's the name of your company?
The Gifted of Dance.
The Gifted of Dance. And his website is?
TheGiftedOfDance.com.
GiftedOfDance.com. And his Instagram?
At TheGiftedOfDance.
All right. How was your Thanksgiving?
Oh, it was good.
Oh, yeah?
those days off were nice.
It was amazing, huh? We finally took off some days. The radio staff normally don't take off. And I have to blame the white man for it. It's James who normally make us work. And so I asked these guys, do you want to be off for Thanksgiving? Or do you want to come in to do the show, and right after the show, you're off? And Joel said yes, and I was stunned. And then I knew James, my producer, would say yes. And then I thought about it. I'm like, nah, I'm going to let these guys off, because they haven't been off in so long. They're so committed. And I'm like, nah, no, I'm going to let you off. And it was a relief. R-O-L-A-I-D. Spell relief. And so nice being off those four days, huh? Three days.
It was so nice.
Yeah. And what'd you do?
I slept in.
Amazing.
Stayed up late, sleep in.
There you go. And how was my producer's here too. James is here. How was yours, James?
It was fun. It was nice. Yeah. Thank you.
And were you glad to be off?
Yeah.
Yeah. And we had, James normally make us work.
Right.
You know how the white people are. They love to work on holidays. Whereas we, the blacks, we look for a day to be off. That's why most black people work for the government, because they take off just thinking about taking off. They take every holiday, they create holidays. But you had a good one too, right?
Yeah. You
spent time with your folks?
Yeah, I went to my family, saw some friends, hung out by myself, hiked, all kinds of things.
Really?
Yep.
That's amazing.
Uh-huh.
And do they like you, your family? You're so conservative now.
Yeah, my family's pretty conservative too.
Oh, they are?
Yeah.
Oh, you're lucky.
Right.
You're fortunate.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. My family, most are liberals.
Yeah.
And it's amazing. Anyway, folks, get a copy of my book, From Rage to Responsibility. I really want to get you past the anger, because once you wake up, and it's God who takes away the spirit of anger. I write about it in my book, From Rage to Responsibility. You can also get the antidote, Healing America from the Poison of Hate, Blame, and Victimhood. I want you to know the way out, and this is for all people, is to overcome the anger. Anger is evil. There's no love in anger. We had an amazing Sunday service yesterday, and a couple of the mothers were talking about how they're controlling their children and how their lives, how they see that they are, but they can't let go. And it's hurting their children, but they can't let go. Isn't that amazing? And the reason for it is the anger. You have no power with anger. I was fortunate in that God took my anger away 29 years ago. And we've been teaching that at my nonprofit organization, Bond, the Brotherhood Organization of a New Destiny. 28 years, been around, no money from the government. We have an entrepreneur academy and all those things. We help find jobs, start businesses. We have a home for young men. It's about character, not color. And we work with all men. We also counsel. We have the best counseling service on this side of heaven. But I want you to get From Rage to Responsibility, but all the books are good that I've written. You can get it at Amazon or any major bookstore, but if you like an autographed copy, go to my website, rebuildingtheman.com, rebuildingtheman.com, or call 800-411-BOND, 800-411-2663. All right? You will not regret it. Read some of the testimonies from the men and women who have overcome anger, and they are now free. They're like, Jesse, I can finally see. I feel like a load has been taken away from me, and that's what's going to happen. You're going to wake up. You're going to return to the kingdom of heaven within, and you're going to see that your battle is spiritual. It has never been physical. It's a lie about racism and blacks and cops, cop brutality and all that crap. All lies. Anyway, James is here, and James is my producer and also the host of the Hake Report. He's on every Sunday at 9 a.m. Pacific time, the HakeReport.com. And I really like that show. I tune in every Sunday. I really do. I look forward to what he has to say. You will not regret it. Check him out. But I asked James to come in because he's saying that some people on YouTube Live, right?
Yeah.
And good morning, YouTube Live. Hi, y'all. I hope you had a good Thanksgiving as well. And they are not happy. Some of the people are not happy with what I'm saying about the shooting down in Sweet Home, Alabama.
Right.
And so what are they saying about it? Where am I wrong?
Some of them are saying you're wrong about this one.
How am I wrong?
They're accusing you of blaming the black people for the cops shooting the wrong guy.
How am I blaming the black people for the cops shooting the wrong guy? Did they say how I am blaming? I'm not blaming the black people for the cops shooting the wrong guy.
They haven't been able to express how you're blaming the blacks for the cops shooting the wrong guy.
Thank you. I'll rest my case again. And, you know, I noticed that when I interview liberals and blacks and radical homosexuals and others, and you can read some of the comments, and they're like calling me names, but they never say I'm wrong about anything. They never say, you had this idiot on, and he's wrong about this, and here's where he's wrong. I am never proven to be wrong. name calling, but not wrong. Isn't that amazing?
One guy says that you say that most of the time, if there's a gathering of blacks, there's a shooting, and that's not true.
That is true. That's true. Is that true, Joel? Not all the time, of course, but when black people get together, especially young black folks, I mean, isn't there some type of fight or shooting or some type of violence breakout? Emma? Yeah.
No, that's true.
Put yourself up there so they can see you black, even though you look white.
No, that is true.
Thank you.
Some kind of drama happens.
You're almost afraid to go to an all-black event.
Right.
Because of that.
Right.
So I don't know what this person's talking about. And so my point is, instead of going out crying racism and coming up with these stupid rally protest thing, why not do it the right way, the decent way? Gather the information, and if the cops are wrong, they'll pay the price for being wrong, but it's not racism. Stop being dumb. That's my point. And we all know when you go to a mall with a bunch of young black people, your life is at risk. Back in a moment. Uniting the races with truth instead of dividing them with lies. We're also rebuilding the family by rebuilding the man. I am Jesse Lee Peterson. Good morning. Hi, y'all. I hope all is well. And I hope you had a good weekend. This week is Thanksgiving. This Thursday. And Nick, did you update my package? I don't see it. And I hope you are safe during the holiday, Thanksgiving holiday. All right? I hope you are safe. Drive safely. They say that Thanksgiving is, if not the most crowded traveling time, it is one of them, that's for sure. So drive safe. Be careful. I also saw a report that on Thanksgiving, 4 hours are long enough. 4 hours are the longest that most families can be together. After 4 hours, a lot of conflict happens. Did you hear that?
No, but makes sense.
They can only hang together on Thanksgiving for 4 hours. And after that, I bet you Nick won't last an hour with his family. 1 hour. I know with my family, as soon as they walk in, it's over. They ask me one thing. Oh, I should mention one thing. It's a big argument. So God bless those who can last for 4 hours. That's a long time. In today's America, Mama America, you can get involved by calling 888-775-3773, 888-77-JESSE. I have a brand new biblical question. Brand new. Listen up closely. And again, these questions are not to test you. These questions are not to test you. They are to get you to think for yourself. Really, I want everybody and their mama to start thinking for themselves. People with degrees, whether it's a psychiatrist, psychologist, doctor, lawyer, Indian chief, preacher, pastor, teacher, reverend, whomever it might be, they're not smarter than you, really. They're not smarter than you. You know what's best for you more than anyone else, all right? So stop turning your lives over to other people. Look what has happened to the blacks. They gave their lives over 70 years, 60 or 70 years ago to the so-called civil rights leaders. They have not returned. The last thing that black people are capable of doing, not all, of course, but most, the last thing that they are capable of doing is thinking as individuals for themselves. And if they should run up on one black person, if black people run up on one black person, man or woman, who think for themselves right away in their minds, that's an enemy. They got to get rid of that person. You are black. Why are you thinking for yourself? You're the white man's boy or girl. They do not want you to be capable of thinking for yourself. The white man must be paying you. You are a free thinker. How did that happen? They don't know that prior to the civil rights movement, black people thought and did for themselves. They just can't even imagine it. What world is that? Because it's not taught to them, and the parents are so corrupt, they're not doing it. So it's amazing. Amazing. So that's why I ask the biblical questions, so that you can think for yourself. And so this week, biblical question, would you rather? No, that's not it. Oh, my God. I thought Nick cleaned it up. See here. Nick, you still sent me the same the way you wrote it and not the way it should be. So let me go and talk to Nick. It's not supposed to be in the chat. It's supposed to be with my package. So James is here. The white man straightened it out. But I have a doozy. It's really, really good. Which do you prefer? I'm surprised Nick didn't do it after all that time out there. Aren't you?
No, it was there.
Which do you prefer? An unclean life or an honorable death? An unclean life or an honorable death? Which do you prefer? I wrote it down on a piece of paper, too, so let me look at it on my piece of little piece of paper. Yeah. Which do you prefer? I want to know. Do you prefer an unclean life or an honorable death? Think about it. Smoke on it. Smoke on it. Let me know. Yesterday, church service, amazing. If you were not there, It is more valuable than silver and gold to see young men and women of all races, really, because there are no colors. There's no color to principles. And to see young men and women waking up, it's just mind-blowing. they're returning to the whole person is coming together now, not just a half talent and half immoral, no values. They are waking up, and all credit goes to the Creator. It's so amazing to see that God, that is, for the atheist folk, is not, not Buddha. All credit goes to God. They are literally waking up, and I'm blown away about it. It just made everything worth it. So right on, wake up. Continue to wake up around the world. They're coming from everywhere, young and old. It's good to see it. Another thing, I heard this report this morning on Fox and Friends, I believe, Fox News there, that fewer and fewer men are signing up to become police officers. It's down really low. And Joel, you remember that soundbite we played where those blacks were throwing buckets, at least one bucket, but water and stuff on the cops?
Yeah.
Are you able to find that for me?
I'll look for it.
Yeah, I want to play that. They showed that this morning, and it was a bunch of black people throwing water, shooting water. They had different soundbites. One is where there was the cops were trying to arrest someone or something in New York, and the blacks were throwing water and threw a bucket at the cops, and another scene where they were walked up to their cars and just sprayed water in the car. You even see a black little kid out there with them. And then another one, so a lot of cops are saying no, a lot of men are saying no to becoming cops because it's just not worth it. It's just not worth it. And I totally understand it. These guys get up in the morning and they say goodbye to their family or late at night, high up, you know, different shifts. And you're going out trying to help protect the good from the bad. And even the so-called good, they ain't good, but they ain't good, jumping on the cops. And when I saw this morning, it reminded me that I have said over and over and over again, I might be the only one saying it out loud. There are definitely other people who agree with it, that black people, the only purpose on earth for blacks today, on earth, is for destruction. So now that they are destroying the police department, and Obama is partly to blame for this because remember when he first got in office, or a little while after he got in, and that stupid so-called black professor at some college in Massachusetts, and said he had this encounter with the cop, and before Obama, the fallen Messiah, the worst president ever, he said the cop acted stupidly without even knowing what the deal was at all. And remember Obama invited Black Lives Matter members from Black Lives Matter to the White House after they were shouting, "What do we want? Dead cops. When do we want it now? Pigs in the blanket, fried like bacon." And now you hear a lot of these black so-called mothers saying, "Oh, I'm so worried about my baby. I tell my baby before they leave the house, y'all watch out there. We don't want you to be killed by the cops." How dumb it is to set your kids up like that. And when something happens, you want to blame the cops and not yourself, right? So I just want to remind you of, here's what happened in New York, I believe.
Outrage this morning over the complete disrespect towards New York City Police Department officers being drenched with water, caught on cell phone video.
Oh, my God.
We'll come back to it, folks. Joel got to wake up this morning.
Outrage this morning over the complete disrespect towards New York City Police Department officers being drenched with water, all caught on cell phone video.
See that little black people?
Oh, my God. They came over here to talk to them that they violated. Yo, they violated
That's what
them.
Black people are on earth for.
They violated them. No, they violated them. Oh, they not stopped.
Oh, man, and that's not the only one. A separate incident on the other side of town. This video showing a bucket being hurled at a cop.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Hit him right in the head.
That's what black people are for. They're not here for anything else on earth but destruction. They don't build, they destroy. And these are men and women, they don't have character. They don't love what's right. They're children of the lie. See that? So I want someone to prove me wrong about this, all right? I have, in all these years, the last 29 years, maybe 30 years of doing radio, I've not had one person to prove me wrong. I've had many blacks to deny it in spite of what they're looking at. They deny it to get mad at me for exposing it, mad at me for trying to wake up black people to turn back to God and be good people, good citizens. You know what I'm saying? But no one has proved me wrong. And so now fewer and fewer men are signing up to become police officers. Can you imagine what that would do to the communities now with these wild people running wild? Because these people don't have, they don't follow the law of God in their hearts. And now they don't have to follow the law of the land. And it's just amazing to see it, folks. And I don't blame these cops, these men and women, for not signing up to be police officers at all. Who want to put their lives on the line for a group of people who hate them for protecting them? Because these people have no sense of free thinking, no character, no morals at all. So black people, that's all you're worth today. You have no other value in the world. Support a party like the Democratic Party that think nothing of you but a vote, but a vote. Anytime these perverted organizations want destruction, they bring in the blacks. All they have to say is, racism, you're treating me like slaves, and the blacks will come marching. But if it's something good and decent and civilized, you're not going to get the blacks out there. Like saving the unborn child, getting married, raising your children, being independent, think for yourself, not as a crowd, but as an individual, not as a tribe, but as an individual. The way the blacks did when I was growing up. And now, you're getting fewer and fewer cops. People signing up to become cops. According to the Washington Post, job applications have declined nearly 50%. Thank you, blacks. You're really doing a great job. And don't say I don't say anything nice about the blacks. I'm saying this. Thank you, blacks. To the blacks, you're doing a great job of destroying the world. Really. It used to be just your communities, your family, your community. Now, it's everybody and everywhere. May God have mercy on the black people. Really. And they don't want to admit that that's what they are for. And because they want to admit it, they cannot overcome it. The only way you will be born again, you must admit you're wrong. And just take full responsibility. And then things will work out. You come back to yourself again. Periscope, creepy scooper, ask, is Jesse wearing a Nigerian soccer jersey? I don't think so. Listen, I bought all these clothes with this little sign thing on it, Nike sign, and then Nike gone creepy on me. But I can't just let these clothes hang out there. I got to wear them. You know what I'm saying? I'm not throwing my money away. So it's a, Nick said that it's a workout shirt. Nick told me this morning when I saw him here at the office. He's like, wow, that's a workout shirt. So that's what this is. Is this a Nigerian color?
It looks a little bit like a soccer shirt, but it's nice to me. I like it.
Right, too. I got a whole bunch of them, to be honest. Different colors. But thank you. I don't know if it's a compliment or put down, but either way, thank you. But that's what this is. It feels nice on the body, easy to wear. There was something else I wanted to tell you. Church was amazing. Men and women are waking up. And it's so amazing because it's just what's fascinating about it is that all I'm doing is telling you the truth about how to get back to the Father. And men and women, boys and girls of all races out there in the world, hearing that, and something is waking up in them. That's mind-blowing to me. Because I've said over and over again that the kingdom of heaven is in sight. What happened was, in the Old Testament, people were going to kill themselves. They had no hope of coming back to the Father. And so God looked down and he said, wow, what the? He's like, Lord, let me get my son and send him down there. Come here, boy. I need you to do a job for me. You see those people down there? They were looking at it on the big screen. They have no way out because of your brother Adam. He listened to the woman, and now the people are suffering because Adam fell away from the Father. Now the people are suffering. And since you and I are still tight, you have not been deceived to turn away from me, your Father. I need you to go down there and make a way for the people that want to return to me will return. Only a few going to do it. I understand that he and Jesus talking about what's going to happen. I understand that the straight road is narrow and only a few are going to find that path. And most of the folks down there, they're going to die. They're doomed. But for those who are willing to look at themselves and admit that they are wrong and want to return to peace, I need you to go down there for me, son, all right? And make a way for them to come back to me. He like, all right, Dad, what you, Daddy? He didn't use the word dad. That's a liberal word. He said, Daddy, what do you want me to do, Daddy? So I want you to go down there. And I want you to create a new reality, a secret world. But this time, buddy, put it on the inside of the person or people. Because I don't want to let anybody in. I'm going to leave this other world open and just let them kill themselves, lie to themselves, deceive themselves, vote for the wrong people that's going to bring misery upon them. I'm going to let them hang out in that old world. I don't want to change that old world, right? I want you to go and create a new world. And those who are willing to know themselves, to admit that they're wrong, those are the ones I bring. I ain't bringing in no anger, resentful, hateful person. All right? That's the nature of their daddy, the devil. That's why they're out there fighting and lying and cheating and stealing and fighting for power and money and all that stuff because Satan is their daddy. So I'm going to leave that outer world there. All right, buddy? But I want you to create this new world and put it inside of them. And by the way, I'm going to send your brother the Holy Spirit. He's a teacher. I'm going to put him in there, too, in that new secret world. And I'll be there. I'll be hanging out with y'all. He said, all right, if I have to, I'll go. I'll gladly go do it. Thank you, Daddy. Stay with me, all right, Daddy? He said, okay. So Christ came, went through hell, everything that we had to endure that would cause us to take a look at ourselves. Christ went through that. And in the end, it was done. And a new world was created. And that new world is inside of us. It's so nice, too. But only those who repent, not those who study the Bible and quote the scriptures and think that they know what they're doing, not those with PhDs, SADs, OYDs, LGBT, GDSDs, or STDs, but only those who repent, I'm going to let in. So he did. And it's amazing what's happening. So thank you. To see these young people and older people waking up is mind-blowing. It really is. It's mind-blowing. So thank you, young folks, for waking up. I don't know where the older folks are. Some show up, but most older people just kind of ran away or something. So my biblical question, which do you prefer, an unclean life or an honorable death? Think about it. Smoke on it. It's so amazing. These people are waking up. They're like, wow, I went and I forgave. They forgave their mothers first for the most part. Sometimes the fathers first, but the mothers, because most people don't realize they need to forgive their mothers. They are so one with mama and not with God and not with their earthly father. They don't realize mama is the problem. Even mamas don't realize they're the problem in most cases. But you got to forgive your mother so you can be born again away from her and take on your father's identity. Amazing stuff. When I come back, your phone calls. Back in a moment. As you heard, Joel, he started his dance academy. He now has two locations. And you just heard him rapping. And he wrote the song. He made the beats and everything. I didn't know Joel could do that. And James, a part of the academy, no longer my radio producer. He's doing his own thing now. He has his own show. The Hake Report, and so on and so on. Get my book, The 7 Guaranteed Steps to Spiritual Family and Financial Success Guide. I use that in the Academy, Entrepreneur Academy. And it's a little simple guide that I wrote because those are the principles I didn't even know I knew. But I did them and they worked. But you got to read it and you got to do it. And they work. If you want an autographed copy, you can go to my website, rebuildingtheman.com, 800-411-2663, all right? Amazing, amazing talents out there. And by the way, I'm looking for a fundraiser person, all right? Someone who really is just self-motivated and you know, have some fun, all right? If you're that person, send me a resume or something to Jesse Lee Peterson, producer at jesseleepeterson.com, I believe, and I'll get it right away, all right? Just FYI, or you can send it to rebuildingtheman.com as well, rebuildingtheman.com. So James is here. I wanted to ask him a quick question. I think I heard him say something, and when he said it, a song popped in my mind. I got a song in my heart. On that news report you gave this morning, didn't you say something like, this guy was running for president. He announced he was running, Bloomberg or somebody.
Right.
And then he said, we can't afford Donald Trump for 4 more years. He would destroy. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
Are you able to be exact? Remind me what you said, because I didn't really hear the whole thing.
Right.
I was preparing for the show. And a song popped in my head when you said it.
He said, quote, we cannot afford 4 more years of President Trump's reckless and unethical actions, which I said is laughable coming from a Democrat.
Right.
He represents an existential threat to our country and our values. If he wins another term in office, we may never recover from the damage.
Amazing. When you said that this song, if there's a cure for this, I don't want it. If there's a cure for what this the Great White Hope has done in almost 4 years, I don't want it.
True.
If there's a remedy, I don't want it.
Nice.
You ever heard that song?
Yeah, I heard a version of it sung by Tupac and somebody else.
Oh, I don't know about Tupac.
Yeah, they.
I know about Diana Ross.
They sang it and rapped it.
Well, Diana Ross made it first.
No, Tupac made it first.
No, if there's a cure for this, I don't want it. I don't want it. If there's a remedy, I run from it. I run from it. Think about it all the time. Can't get it out of my mind because I love you. I got something hangover.
I don't remember her singing that song.
You weren't born yet.
I know, but I went to see her sing one time.
Oh, yeah, in Vegas.
Yeah.
Maybe you got there late.
Probably.
But Diana Ross made it before some Tupac or Tupac mama or anybody else.
Tupac.
So I don't want a remedy
right.
for Donald Trump. I don't want a cure.
Yep.
Keep me the way it is. It's amazing.
I agree.
But I didn't know Tupac even made it. Where's Tupac now?
He did.
I rest my case.
And she's he still did. Living.
Who?
Diana
That's
Ross.
That's right. Diana Ross is the boss.
She and Bruce Springsteen are the bosses?
If you doubt me, ask Michael Jackson.
He's dead.
He dead.
Why do you say that?
Because I think she made a song that he wrote, Muscles All Over My Body or something.
He wrote it and she sang it?
Yeah.
Really?
I think Michael wrote it. I believe Michael Jackson wrote it about muscles.
Yeah.
Something like if she says she want a man that always understand, that's all right for her, but ain't enough for him. He want muscles. You heard that, John?
No.
That's he used to play it on the bumpers.
Yeah. When we could,
maybe when
we used to be able to play copyrighted music.
Yeah, Andre was here then.
Yeah.
And that was copyrighted.
How come all the older songs all have that same kind of melody? Every time you start singing them, I know they came from like 70s or earlier.
Soul. Black people used to have soul. Now they got an empty hole. Anyway, but I don't want a cure to Donald Trump, so I don't want Bloomberg.
Yeah, I agree.
If there's a remedy, I don't want it.
I don't know why he thinks that he can win. He has no appeal.
Suppose he had a lot of money.
That doesn't mean anything.
Plus, he was a Democrat, a Republican. No, he started out Republican.
No,
I believe.
He started out Democrat, and then he became a Republican,
and then
he became an independent. And then just last year, he became a Democrat again, and he's 77.
Who want a confused person like that?
And he's not like an energetic 77 like some people might be in
right.
the future. he's like a kind of decrepit-looking plastic surgery face type of 77. And he doesn't seem like a genuine person at all. Anyways.
I know. He looked like he just there.
Yep.
Just
like
there.
Most of them.
No energy. I was talking to a family member on the phone and last night, and she would tell me about one of my cousins who lives out here. Husband died. And they had no children. They had been married for a while, but they had no children. I think 12 years or maybe more, give or take. And they had no children. And I said, oh, wow. I said, that's good. She said, no, that's not good because when she get older, she said, at least you need to have one child. I'm like, why? So that when you get older, you will have somebody to take care of you. I'm like, what? A child is not an investment. God didn't want you to have babies so you have somebody to take care of you. But that's the mentality of a lot of people. They're having, especially women, I think more so women than men, they're having children not so that God can create love through them, But so that the kids can take care of it. No wonder the mamas are following their adult kids around with that kind of mentality.
Yeah.
I'm like, what the? She said you should at least have one so that they can take care of you.
Crazy.
I can't say her name because I'm going over there for Thanksgiving. But I might run over there and have a little soul
candy
food.
Yams.
Yeah, candy yams, sweet potato pie. And I don't want her to say, you can't have none of my pie. I heard what you said about me on the radio.
Well, it's not like she still doesn't know who you're talking about if you're watching.
I'm just playing. You can have one child to take care of you.
They can be slaves as when they're your kids, when they're pre-adult. Have them to work the farm. Have a bunch of kids so that they can work the farm.
Mow the lawn.
Yeah. Well, you're not supposed to be having children to take care of you.
Right.
I remember once when my son was mad at me, and he had asked me for some money. Something happened, right? And I said, no. He's like, well, that's all right. When I become grown and you get old, I'm not going to take care of you. I'm like, what? I never even imagined him taking care of me. It just didn't even occur to me. And he was like all serious about it.
How old was he at this point?
He was like in a teenager years.
Okay.
You're going to get old. I'm not going to take care of you.
That's funny.
I'm like, thank God. If I have to invest in you now so you can take care of me, I'm losing this one. This is an investment I don't want. That's not the reason to have children.
Yeah, that's a risk.
You're supposed to be taking care of your own life as you get older. And if you do retire, you'll have your own money to take care of yourself.
Yep.
But I guess some women think that their babies are for them. They're having these babies so that these babies can take care of them. No wonder so many adult men and women talking about, I got to take care of mama. My mama living at my house. I'm taking care of her.
I think they also think it because they took care of their parents.
Who?
The parents who say, I'm going to have a baby so they can take care of me because they resent taking care of their parents.
But in the good old days when boys were boys and men were men, that didn't happen. I know that some home where the elderly died there, but with my grandmother, when she became old, because everybody left. You know, as they were getting 18 and up, they left. Everybody gone. So eventually, she was living by herself. Mm-hmm. And quite satisfied with it. She used to say, I'm glad to see y'all coming, and I'm glad to see you leave. Because she liked her quiet time after a while. You know, she was settled. She and my granddaddy. But, so when she became old, just absolutely could not do for herself, they had to make her move to Indiana.
And then where'd she?
And then when she moved to Indiana, she didn't want to stay with them. So they had these big apartment buildings for the elderly. She wanted her own place.
Yeah.
So they got her apartment at that building, and she stayed by herself and played with the old people until she died.
Nice.
She just stayed independent. She didn't want to be a burden to her kids. She didn't raise her kids so that they could take care of her. They had their own family. Isn't that amazing?
Yep.
And so you never thought, oh, my mama had me so I can take care of my mama. As Joel would say, what?
That's so logical, though. What you said, it just seems logical. Why would you even want your kids to take care of you?
But why would you even have that mentality?
Right.
And when God married people, he sent them away from their family. Go and start your own family. Don't hang around mama. She going to want you to take care of her.
Yep.
You don't hear the fathers fathering the kids around for the most part. Let them obey the daddy.
That's true.
So that they'll take care of them. It's the mother thing.
Yeah, that's true.
Men, these women need y'all. Women need men to bring them out of that. I want to show you, Joel has, even though he didn't mention it at all this morning, we're supposed to be playing
last week, Friday and Monday.
He mentioned it Friday and Monday. What's today?
Today is Monday.
No, right.
You mentioned it to who today?
I told you on Friday. We'll play it Friday and Monday.
But I know, but did you mention it today?
I told you on Friday and Monday.
That makes sense?
No, it
if I have something I want to promote, I tell you on Friday,
you gotta
Monday.
You got to remind us the day of.
I'm telling you, it's my thing.
I got to get used to how.
It's my thing I'm promoting.
I got to get used to how you think. You're right. Because you should have reminded. But I did say
everybody needs to be reminded.
What do you mean by how I think?
No, because I told you Friday and Monday. So that's why.
But today and Monday.
I already had it ready in here. Look, it's already in the queue. It's already up.
But if I go.
But you have to. You have to be like, hey, Jesse, remember, we got to promote my thing.
You're running your own business. You want to make sure it's promoted.
Right, it's here, right?
Because it wasn't in the packet. You probably didn't give it to Nick. And it's so Jesse's not thinking about it.
They don't ever put it in the packet for me.
You don't know. You don't ever tell him.
Ask him.
It always still gets played.
He will put it there if you ask him to.
But it always still gets played.
All because I feel sorry for you.
Well, the sorry is working.
I ain't your daddy.
Okay, can we play my promo today?
So tell us what we're about to. What's happening?
Okay, so. What this is here is a preview of the episode that's dropping tonight at 5 p.m. on YouTube.com/TheGiftedOfDance. So make sure it's already premiere. It's already set to premiere. So just go click the link and then hit the button for the reminder. And it's a new episode tonight. The episode is called The Apology. It's interesting.
And the episode is a part of what?
The Gifted of Dance series. So I have a YouTube reality series for the new watchers and listeners.
Thank you. And so this is the second episode tonight at 5, you say?
Tonight at 5. This is episode 2. Episode 1 is already up on the YouTube, so you can check that out if you missed it. But this is episode 2 today, and it's coming out at 5 tonight.
Let me see it.
Here's the promo.
I think he explains things well. Of course, there's been a lot of drama between the team and him. And I think he's been handling it okay.
You guys don't want to get better, and you guys just want to look crazy, that's on you. If you guys want to skip days, there's consequences for them. But I'm not forcing you to have to come. Heather decided to make a decision not to come for the reason that she had. I'm not going to say the reason. She can tell you if she wants. And she's going to have to suffer the consequences when she came back. But I gave her the decision. And she chose not to come.
But that's the same way you played last week.
No, on Friday he played it.
Oh, Friday.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Oh, okay. So check it out on
YouTube.com/TheGiftedOfDance and hit the reminder button.
Oh, yeah, it was Friday. So it's about this upcoming episode. Check it out, folks. It's amazing. And I want you to know, Joel is black, all right? Ain't no white man holding him back. No white man holding him back. It's a lie that they be telling you this. He black. He black. 30% white, but he black. And he has overcome the mama, returned to the father, entered the kingdom of heaven within, living upright, and things are working out. They're going amazingly well. It's mind-blowing. So that's tonight at 5 p.m. Check it out. And remind you, Joel has his own business, too. Two locations of his dance studio. It could be done. You just have to come back to common sense and stop listening to the Old Testament people out there in the world. They're liars. They're blind. They can't see. They don't know what you know. They don't know what your father is secretly showing you and teaching you within. There's a new heaven inside. Jack is out of Massachusetts. Jack, thank you for calling, and thanks for holding. You're on the air.
Hey, Jesse. Good morning.
Good morning, Jack. This is the house that Jack built, y'all.
Hey, so I'm not sure that you remember. It was a while ago, and I know you take a lot of calls. But
and plus, I'm black. Never ask a black man if he remember. You see how Joel doesn't remember the appetite.
I'm not even sure I remember at this point.
Right.
But I called you a few times last year about forgiving my mother and coming back to the father.
Yes.
And I've been looking for an opportunity to call you and just give you an update on how things went after that.
Amazing.
So, last year, I went to my mother, and I forgave her, and She didn't take it very well. She actually got very angry at me. But it did. I just want to let you know it did wonders, and it completely changed my life around. And I'm about 2 weeks away from shipping out because I joined the military.
Amazing.
And, yeah, everything just went so perfectly. I was in a terrible, terrible place before then, and I just wanted to call and let the people who are listening to know that the advice that you're giving them is dead on. It's absolutely right.
That's so amazing, Jack. I absolutely appreciate that. And now that you're going into the military with a clear mind rather than anger in your heart, you all have to worry about post—what do they call it?
Post-traumatic
stress disorder. Because God is with you, and you know it, and you would deal with the situations in a different way.
That's absolutely true, and I've actually helped a couple of friends of mine who thought that they were thought that they had mental illness or anxiety or whatever it is that they're saying these days. And I've actually helped a couple people by showing them that it's actually the spiritual battle, and that they're not mired in this nightmare of anxiety or whatever the liberal media is telling people to say.
Yeah. It is so crazy that human beings would listen to the so-called experts and others of the world. Those people have no idea what they're talking about. Their knowledge is just empty knowledge that only brings on destruction. It doesn't bring life at all.
No, and it plays with this sort of victim mentality where people— I mean, we're meant to struggle. Struggle is just a natural part of life, and people like to buy into this idea that their struggle is actually some sort of illness,
right,
that they're suffering.
Yeah.
But it's not at all. And so I've actually helped a few friends of mine just from your teachings and from some other folks and just standing up straight and being a man. So.
Right on, Jack. This is an amazing call, man. I wish you well in the military, and let me hear from you again, and I'm glad to hear that you are now being an example, a living example for others to find their way. That's the way it's supposed to be.
That's right, and I plan to keep that tradition going forward. Quickly, can I just answer your biblical question?
Yes. Which do you prefer, an unclean life or an honorable death?
I much prefer an honorable death, and having lived an unclean life for as many years as I did before— that's a very easy decision to make.
Amazing. Well, I appreciate you responding to my biblical question. Hopefully, I put my little two cents in on Sunday morning.
All right. I'll be listening.
Jack, I wish you well, man. You made my day.
All right. Thank you. You've made mine.
All right, buddy. God bless you in the military.
Thank you. Take care.
All right, now. Amazing. Isn't that, like, amazing? Nice. That's just amazing. Life is so amazing. No such thing as racism, sexism, homophobiaism, Islamophobiaism, deadbeat dadism. No ism, folks. No slayism. No Jim Crowism. It's about right or wrong, good or evil. It's a spiritual battle. So stop listening to these titles that the children of the lie, the world, put on issue. Drinking is not a disease. It's not a disease. It comes from conflict that you have separated from God due to judging as a kid, becoming angry at mama and turning away from your father. And you have conflict because you're not connected to life. It's not a disease. Everything ain't no disease. Earl is out of Michigan. Hey, Earl.
Jesse.
How you doing, Earl?
I'm doing fine.
Good, man. You called just to say hi?
I've called. No, I didn't call just to say hi.
He has here. You just want to say hi.
Say what?
You told Nick you called. You just want to say hi.
No, I didn't tell that. Nick didn't say that. I said I was talking in general. I called to touch on.
It didn't say that, so I'm reading it here. It does say, just want to say hi.
Well, that's not what I said. I think Nick probably made just a miscalculation. I said,
yeah,
touch on some of the things I said Friday. And basically, talk in general.
Oh, okay. Go ahead.
Think about it. You know, going back to what we talked about Friday, you talked to 17 from Missouri, and y'all touched on it.
17 what? I'm sorry. 17 what?
Of topics. 17 of Missouri. You know, he went by the nickname of 17 from Missouri.
Do you know what he's talking about?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, you had a caller named 17.
Oh, okay. Go ahead, Earl.
Yeah, and you talked on a litany of topics. One of the things you talked about, he asked you a question about being black and so forth. And one thing you complain about, the reason you don't associate with blacks is because they complain and they whine and they dig. And
well, I don't know if I didn't say I didn't associate with black, because I do associate with some black. I don't identify with being black.
Yeah, you don't identify
right.
with certain blacks.
Right. No, I don't identify with being black.
Yeah. So.
Earl is like a snake in the grass. He tried to deceive people the way he speak. He say things.
No, I didn't be a snake in the grass.
He say things that you didn't say because he's a dishonest person, and he's like a snake in the grass.
Yeah. True.
I remember growing up in Alabama, these snakes would be crawling in the woods, and they would be changing color with the leaves. And you can't tell. So you have to really pay attention. That's Earl.
Yeah, because I catch you on all your lies and all your mistruths. And I spit it back at you, and you call it being a snake in the grass.
No, you're saying that I said things that I didn't say, Earl.
Well, one thing also, you never did name anything that you say good about black folks.
I said blacks are on earth to destroy.
I said you never said anything good about black folks.
I said something good, Earl. I said black people are on earth to destroy, not to build.
No, that's not nothing good about blacks.
Then why are they doing it then? If they don't think it's good, why are they doing it?
You said,
Earl, wait. I'm going to let you say what you need to say. But if they don't say it's good, why are they doing it?
That's the whole different question. Is it good that what you say that they're doing? Is that something to be proud of?
Well, apparently they are proud of it. They are doing it.
No, that's what you're saying. But you're saying that as a detriment to blacks. You're not saying that as a compliment.
No, that's a compliment. So, that's all they do, so I have to compliment them on that. They are now known as a culture of people created for destruction. Congratulations.
No, that's just stupid. That's an idiotic comment with the brain of a moron would say.
So is it stupid for me to congratulate them, or is it stupid that they are doing it?
It's stupid. It's stupid. Your comment all around is stupid.
How is that?
I don't have to go into stupidity to explain stupidity.
James is here to hate report. So is it stupid for me to congratulate them, or is it stupid that they are doing it?
The stupidest thing is that they're doing it.
And shouldn't I congratulate them? Because apparently they think it's good.
I never knew you congratulate them. Sometimes you do. You're like, congratulations, black people.
Yeah. They think they're doing good. They're doing it year in and year out, generation to generation. They're doing it. So that's why apparently they think it's good. So congratulations, black people.
Yeah.
That's just stupid. But the thing you commented to me Friday was that you said good about blacks was before the civil rights movement, they were decent and all that other stuff.
Yes.
Yeah, but problem is, Jesse, you're contradicting yourself.
How's that?
You said the past don't exist. So what
right.
is good about black folks?
If you notice, they don't exist either. I rest my case.
What good are you saying about
so
black
folks? So the decent blacks don't exist now. Am I right?
One good thing about black folks and you could, all you could name was something in the past that you said they were good. That, and then you said, in the past don't exist. So when the people bring up the past, you you dismiss them. But then you can't name anything good about Black spirit.
I just another named thing, something. They're very destructive, Earl.
And that's good, right?
Apparently they think so, so yes.
No, no, that's stupid, Jim.
Why are they doing it then? Why are they doing it?
Why are they doing it or not, it doesn't make it complimentary.
That's what they think. They have no shame.
No, that's what you say.
Earl, thank you for calling me, Earl. I got to take a break. Back in a moment. You know, Christmas is coming up. Thanksgiving and Christmas and New Year's, all that coming up. I have some amazing books that would make for excellent gifts. I have the antidote, Healing America from the Poison of Hate, Blame, and Victimhood. And then Rage, From Rage to Responsibility. Check it out. Scam, How the Black Leadership Exploits Black Americans. And last but not least, A Little Small Pocket Guide, The 7 Guaranteed Steps to Spiritual, Family, and Financial Success Guide. Just a little thin piece of book. But it's so good. So check them out. You can go to rebuildingaman.com or call 800-411-BOND, 800-411-2663. And I can sign them if you order them that way. If you don't want me to sign them, no problem. You can order from Amazon.com, all right?
Welcome to Hour 2 of the Jesse Lee Peterson Show. I'm James Hake. Jesse will be back in just a moment. Hang tight, callers and everybody else. It's Monday, November 25th, 2019. Hake News. Not so much fake news. We'll see. Drudge reports, Schiff is open to more public hearings. Of course, NBC so-called news reports, House so-called Intelligence Committee Chairman Adam Schiff, Democrat from California, told Sleepy Eyes Chuck Todd of NBC, Don't foreclose the possibility of more hearings. Will Bolton flip the gaps or fill the gaps? I forgot about John Bolton. LA Times reports Bolton's name frequently popped up in the last 2 weeks of hearings before the House so-called Intelligence Committee. Administration officials described his disgust, Bolton's disgust, at the pressure campaign, which is a liberal buzzword, by the way, pressure campaign, that Trump's lawyer Rudolph W. Giuliani had set in motion to push Ukraine into publicly announcing their investigations into Trump's Democrat rivals, meaning former Vice President Joe Biden and the Democrat DNC server stuff. This slanted narrative is used by all the extreme anti-Trump outlets, AP, New York Times, Adam Schiff, Daily Beast, CNN, Nancy Pelosi, Wall Street Journal, David Axelrod, all the far left and Trump haters and rhinos are using that term pressure campaign. Bolton is establishment and a rhino. Drudge reports, Reverend Franklin Graham says opposition to the president is demonic. Washington Examiner reports, Graham spoke on Thursday last week with author and host Eric Metaxas, who interviewed the 67-year-old son of the late Billy Graham. Metaxas said, it's a very bizarre situation to be living in a country where some people seem to exist to undermine the president of the United States, Metaxas said. It's just a bizarre time for most Americans. Graham responded, well, I believe it's almost a demonic power that is trying, and then Metaxas interrupted, I would disagree, it's not almost demonic. You know and I know at the heart, it's a spiritual battle. And they're right. Nunes, as in Devin Nunes, the House guy, could face a second ethics investigation. Of course, right? Geez, these so-called ethics investigators are corrupt. Washington Examiner reports via Greenwich Time. A high-ranking House Democrat said Saturday it's quite likely Representative Devin Nunes, Republican from California, will face an ethics investigation over allegations that he met with an ex-Ukrainian official to obtain information about former Vice President Joe Biden and his son Hunter, who did some suspicious things, right? Representative Adam Smith of Washington, the chairman of the House Armed Services Committee, appeared on the far-left MSNBC, where he was asked whether Nunes could face a House inquiry. Quite likely, without question, Smith said. The allegation came from attorney for Lev Parnas, who was one of the two Soviet-born associates of Rudy Giuliani, who were indicted on charges that they broke campaign finance law. Who knows? Drudge reports that gun supporters are prepared to defy new laws. Washington Post reports via MSN, people are pushing for counties to declare themselves Second Amendment sanctuaries in Virginia and elsewhere. Virginia is where Democrats wrote on a platform of gun control to historic victories in state elections earlier this month. In the past 2 weeks, county governments from the central Piedmont to the Appalachian Southwest, Charlotte, Campbell, Carroll, Appomattox, is that how you pronounce it? Appomattox? Patrick, Dinwiddie, Pittsylvania, Lee, and Giles have approved resolutions that defy Richmond to come take their guns. Last year in Western states, law enforcement officials vowed to go to jail rather than enforce firearm restrictions, which are violations to the right to keep and carry guns. In New Mexico, 25 of 33 counties declared themselves Second Amendment sanctuaries after the state expanded background checks. In Illinois, nearly two-thirds of its counties have done the same. And so in the Virginia, sheriffs are doing the same thing. Good for them. I'm James Hake. Now on to Jesse.
Understand what went wrong. I know we can find a way. I know we can find a way. I know we can find a way to stand up. Stand up. Stand up.
Uniting the races with truth instead of dividing them with lies. We're also rebuilding the family by rebuilding the man. I'm Jesse Lee Peterson. Happy Thanksgiving, folks. Realize, be grateful, reflect on life, and be grateful for all things. And life is amazing. Really, be grateful for the ups and the downs. Treat them both the same. They're both imposters. So happy Thanksgiving to you. If I were you, do what you want, but if I were you, I wouldn't let someone tell me what I can and cannot do with my family, where I can and cannot go. That is me. Do what you want. I'm going to do my norm for Thanksgiving. Really. My biblical question, who is the Christian's worst enemy? Who is the Christian's worst enemy? Enemy. That's my biblical question for this week. And I'll put my two cents in on Sunday. Manhood Hour is coming up in the next hour. James Hake is coming up at 9 a.m. this morning. And James Hake is on fire. We don't understand it at the office. We're trying to figure out what the. But James Hake is on fire. TheHakeReport.com at 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. Pacific time. I am building a network of young men to have their own show. It's going to be amazing. Really. We got to get men out there. Men got to be in the forefront. God created it that way. We are created by God so to bring love into the world. That's the purpose. Everybody want to know, what's my purpose? Oh, I can't find my purpose. Oh, where's my purpose? I miss my purpose. You're not missing your purpose in life. You're missing a return to the Father. But Satan and his children tell you you're missing a purpose. Once you return to the Father, your purpose, your talent, whatever you want to call it, will find you. It's a spiritual thing. But you are created so that God can create love through you. That's how he create love and come through, especially men, to the women, to the children. All right, so don't worry about your purpose. Worry about a return to the Father. Be concerned about that. And life will be amazing. And whatever you're doing with your hands, you will be totally satisfied. Because it's not, you won't look at it as an identity. It'll be a way of earning a living. That's it. Anyway, Super Chats and D-Live.
Super Chats.
Super Chats.
All right. Let's take a look. Noah's Arkansas with a diamond. No message. Thanks.
Thank you.
General Pawn with a diamond. Cuomo gets Emmy. What the? For being a beta, LOL.
Yeah, that's the world. The world take care of its own, and it destroys its own. Okay.
With a diamond. With a diamond, and his message is with a diamond. Incredible stuff. Hydro PX with a diamond. Do you think women are taking over Bond?
Taking over Bond? What's our organization?
I guess it's lowercase, but
no, I know you're just playing, right? No, they're not. They're definitely a big asset tomorrow. Though. They help out, volunteer, they whenever we need it. Thank you, ladies. I appreciate it. Okay.
Tynobot with a diamond. Want to defeat COVID? Stop getting
there
tested.
There are, speaking of women, there are a couple ladies that I might invite to have their show on this network because I think they'll be pretty good. And I want to, at some point, I want to do a town hall with the Bond women dealing with other women, the worldly women or whatever. I think that'll be good too. All right.
LL Cool Nate with a diamond. Coming for your guns. Conspiracy until it ain't.
Yep.
Yordanos.
In Philadelphia, I just heard a report that I believe it was on Fox and Friends this morning that in Philadelphia, I think it was Philly. I may be wrong about the city or the state. But in Philly, I believe they are not selling you, they are not allowing you to apply for a license or permit to buy a gun now. They've shut that down. A lot of people are not liking that. But I'm not surprised when you allow these liberal Democrats to take over, they take away your rights. I'm starting to hear more now about illegal aliens coming in, amnesty, and all the things that I've forgotten about. Because the Great White Hope was bringing the country back to order. But now that these liberals think that they are taking over, they are openly, they want to bring in refugees and everything. It's a mess. So I believe it was Philadelphia where you cannot get a license right now. They've shut it down. They're using the Chinese virus as an excuse for that. It's mind-blowing, but it's a battle between good and evil. Okay.
Yordanos with a diamond. Love you. Have a happy Thanksgiving Day,
thank you.
Jesse.
You too. Thank you very much. Don't eat too much turkey. And by the way, we are doing the show live. I asked my producer, Nick, this morning, are we doing the show live tomorrow? He said, yes. So we will be here on Thanksgiving Day. Okay.
Hello, cool.
The office is closed. Sorry. The office is closed Thursday and Friday, but we will be doing the show live both days. Joya doesn't want to. He black. He had all kind of reasons. I got to go to my mama. What the? He black.
LL Cool Nate with a diamond.
Are you hiding your face?
Joel is, yeah.
No. You have on your black shirt today, your African shirt.
Yeah.
What the? What made you decide to wear your African? It's not Kwanzaa.
What is the... What does the DGK stand for?
Dirty Ghetto Kid.
Oh, that's why you're wearing it.
And I discovered it after I bought it,
Right.
But it's still a nice shirt.
Even though it's not Kwanzaa?
Right.
What the?
Next month.
All right. That's a little black in you.
LL Cool Nate with a diamond kung flu.
Is this
be
black
the last
nationalism? Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead. I don't know what James talking about. Go ahead.
LL Cool Nate with a diamond. Kung flu will be the last jump to tyranny. Bank on it.
Everybody was kung fu fighting. Ugh. Okay.
LL Cool Nate with a diamond. What happens with a disease with an 80% survival rate?
Amazing.
LL Cool Nate with another diamond. Look what we allow with a 95% survival disease.
Yep.
Joe Maddock with a diamond. Democrats are of their father, the devil.
I can't believe that they are willing to make people get fired, lose their businesses, get on welfare, make them rely on the government because they know the people will not take a stand. That is mind-blowing to want to control someone that badly, that you would destroy their lives just to take control over them. That's what it's all about. These little nothing men and women taking control of people. It's mind-blowing. Anyway.
LL Cool Nate with a diamond. Watching sports equals beta. Go do something.
Yep.
Tino Bot with a diamond. Jesse, is the Pope still ticked?
Oh, the Pope is ticked. The Pope might be happy with all this mess because the Pope ain't no good. The Pope dad is Satan. I'm just saying. But anyway.
Tinobot with a diamond. Chris has the muscles and the stash. Killing it. Thank you, Tinobot. Nice.
Oh,
great,
God.
Great message.
Oh, amazing.
Soul Warrior 2020 with a diamond. Trump Kanye 2024.
Yep.
All right, that's cool. June Valentino with a diamond. Joel Jelly, he can't grow a Chris mustache. LOL, JK.
That's true.
Thank God, huh? No. It's nice.
Thank you. Lin Yan Chin with a diamond. Original Jesse equals right. Parent alone apologizes. Not sure. He continues on. Apologize equals accept responsibility. More from Lin Yan Chin. Children aren't responsible for their upbringing. Forgive, not apologize for parenting you received. Mike Young with a donation. Hey, Joel, don't worry about Chris. You're still the man.
Nice.
He black.
Some serious battle going on here. Soul Conscious with a donation. Jesse, happy Thanksgiving to you and crew. Love you guys.
Thank you. Absolutely. Same back at you. Happy Thanksgiving and appreciate you. Love you as well.
Noah's Arkansas with a diamond. Turtle No Neck with a diamond. Jesse, why do you support a people who blaspheme Christ?
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. That's all he said.
Oh, okay.
Call
me. 888-775-3773.
Tinobot with a diamond. Jesse needs to run for governor of California.
Yep.
Arizona lineman with a diamond. Oh, Cory Booker. Cory Booker is going to take your land.
Told y'all, white folks, they going to take your land. If you let them in, they going to take your land. Say hello to South Africa. It is in full operation now here in America, unfortunately. Okay.
Joe Maddock with a diamond. Kamala Harris hasn't quit as California senator. Wonder why. Joe Maddock with a diamond.
I've been hearing liberal blacks saying that the governor should replace Kamala Harris with another black woman. Not a qualified person, but another black woman. They should put her, a black woman, in the Senate. Not qualified. They don't want the best. They want a black woman. And a liberal black one at that, not a conservative black one. It's so crazy, but that's the world. That's Satan and his world. Okay.
Joe Maddock with a diamond. I like that throwback suspenders. Throwback suspenders wearing, Jesse, your background.
Oh, thank you. Nice. That's my Thanksgiving background, by the way. as well.
Nice. Yeah. All right, and that's all for now.
Thank you all so much. I do appreciate it, folks. Happy Thanksgiving to you. For personalized shout-outs, whether it's Thanksgiving, Christmas, encouragement, birthdays, funerals, weddings, divorces, whatever. Cameo, cameo.com/Destiny Peterson. And thank you to patreon.com, subscribestar.com, and rockfin.com/Destiny Peterson. Exclusive content for you as well. You can always find my show at DestinyPeterson.com/show, all right? DestinyPeterson.com/show. And I do appreciate all of your support, your financial support, your volunteer, your prayers, your well wishes, everything. Nothing is taken for granted. Thank you, folks. If it wasn't for you, we couldn't do what we're doing. We're getting it done because we're all in this together. So thank you very much. Earl is out of Michigan. Earl, welcome to the show. You're on the air.
Hola, Senor Jesse Peterson. Buenos dias.
How you doing, Earl?
Fine. I'm doing fine.
Nice.
I mean, fine.
Happy Thanksgiving, Earl.
Same to you, Jesse, and your staff.
Thank you, man. Are you going to your family for Thanksgiving?
No.
You're not?
No.
You just going to stay home alone?
No. But that's my business.
You said that's my business. Amazing. Well, happy Thanksgiving, Earl.
Yes. Appreciate it. You know, you had a caller Monday, Kirk from Georgia. He talked about his business being helped by affirmative action and so forth by Maynard Jackson, by the moves of Maynard Jackson, opening up the process so blacks could get a foothold and compete. In fact, Maynard Jackson started the Renaissance in black in the middle, bringing up the middle class in Atlanta. It was an avalanche of businesses and jobs. People were flocking to Atlanta because of the avalanche of jobs and black owned businesses and so forth. So that was a help. To blacks getting a foothold.
Are you for that affirmative action for the blacks?
Yes.
What is wrong with you people that you need affirmative action? Why can't you do it on your own? What happened to the blacks? Because I would think that the blacks would be embarrassed for the world to know that they are not capable of even starting their own business, doing their own things. Is that they need affirmative action. Why don't, number one, what happened to you people that you need affirmative action, and why can't you overcome it so that you could be as strong as the white men are? What's wrong with you? And you're not ashamed to let the world know you couldn't do it on your own. Why not?
I don't know if you knew, but people should remember John D. Rockefeller.
No, you're not answering the question. I want to know what happened to you people that you're not ashamed to let the world know you can't make it on your own. I'm going to answer it
by pointing out the same difference that you point out for blacks. Now, when I say John D. Rockefeller, who owned Standard Oil, had a monopoly. You know, they broke up the monopoly so whites could get a foothold, and the government broke it up so whites could get a foothold and compete. The smaller companies that were stumped out and so forth, the antitrust suits made a way, just like Maynard Jackson did with affirmative action, except for white folks who wasn't called a mainly affirmative action. The same way with Marbell, if you remember AT&T, when that monopoly was broken up by the government, so smaller companies like Sprint and other companies could compete.
Well, you're still not telling me what's wrong with the black. What? When I was growing up, I'm thinking of some of the things that were happening is that my aunt and her husband got married to this guy, a black guy, and she was black, and they bought land, and they had like almost maybe 15 to 16 children, and all of their kids went, not only to finish high school, but they all went to college and graduated from college, and when they finished, they too bought land, homes, and things in different parts of the world, of the country. And my family, when they, growing up in Alabama, we never went without. And when we left home, we all bought land. We went to work. They got married. What? And they didn't need Leonard Jackson, whatever his name is, or affirmative action.
Leonard Jackson.
Whatever. But after that, something happened to the blacks where they became weak, and the lack of shame about letting the world know that they were weak and begging, and they firmly believe that white people are superior to them, that white people are smarter, white people work harder, and all they have to do is sit back and take the white man's stuff and feel good about it. What happened to y'all?
Nothing. Nothing happened to us no more than what happened to the white folks.
What
happened?
Needed
a hand from the government to break up companies so they can compete. When you have companies or entities dominating that have closed off any access to the market and so forth, sometimes the government thinks it's better that other folks can compete by breaking up and allowing other folks to get a piece of the pie. But they don't.
And
they
so
just don't call
are
it
you,
when
are
white
you,
folks do it. They just don't call it affirmative action, which is affirmative. In effect,
are you
the same
saying
thing
that
as
the black
action.
People only thought the black people thought that the only way they can make it by way of the government, they have to do government? Because I remember at one time when I first started Bond, it was a report out that says 80% of black people who were employed by the government. And so are you saying that the blacks lost the capability of making their own way, so they needed the government to do it for them?
No, that's not what I'm saying, Jesse.
But everything you just said was about what the government did for them. In
well,
my
government
days,
had to step in. Just
in
like
my
they
good
had to
days,
step in
we didn't have the government.
AT&T.
But in my day, we didn't have the government
do
doing it for us. I didn't even know the government did that for the votes, to be honest.
Just because you didn't know it, the world, there's a big world out there that just didn't consist of you and your family, Jesse.
But there were other black people, too, that were doing very well.
There was other black people. There was a lot of black people all over the country that didn't have the access and so forth that you did.
But why not? What was wrong with them that they couldn't make it on their own? They needed the government.
It was just establishment business in place that didn't allow folks to compete.
But so why didn't they work around that and not compete, but just did their best and enjoyed life and let their natural talent come out like they did when I was growing up? What happened to the blacks?
And this, just because of your situation, that's the way it was with everybody, right?
Nothing
happened.
Even my best friend, his father and mother bought land. And I remember I used to have to stay home to pick cotton and work the cotton fields and do the plants and, plantation. And my best friend never missed school because his family were independent. They had their own land. They did their own thing. And they were black. I don't know why black. I do know why.
You make anecdotal examples as if that was like that everywhere.
Right. And I'm trying to figure out what happened to the rest of you black people that y'all felt like y'all can't make it. Y'all need the government. Y'all need to take from the white man.
Is that the same way white folks felt when the government stepped in to help them?
And so that's why you did it, because the white people knew it.
You just don't label them that.
What?
You just don't label them when the government steps in and helps them, like breaking up monopolies and other consortiums that prevent them, some smaller companies, from competing. You don't call that affirmative action.
What do you
call
it?
When the government helps them, do you?
What do you call it?
Only when black government steps in to help black folks that you think it should be a shame to get assistance from the government.
Why don't you think it should be a shame?
Otherwise blocked off avenues.
Why don't you think it should be a shame for black people to be proud for the world to know they can't make it on their own?
Why isn't that? Who cares what the world knows? Did the world care when they blocked it off to keep it between themselves so nobody else could compete?
Well, they didn't know that the black people were going to be begging and blaming, because blacks used to be independent.
That's stupid, Jesse. Who cares what they knew or not? You don't know what they know. You're just making up statements.
Why do you people believe that white people are superior?
We don't believe white folks are superior.
Do you believe there's something called white supremacy?
Society, Jesse, tells you that there was an America that it catered to white folks. And therefore,
it catered to anyone who stood up and were willing to take care of themselves. I remember Booker T. Washington. He grew in slavery. He was born enslaved. His folks were sold off. He ended up on his own. And because he didn't hate and he strived in life, he had help that came from white people, black people. He went on and founded Tuskegee Institute, and a whole lot of things. And the white folks didn't hold him back way back then during slavery time. So I don't understand why you blacks are accepting that white people are superior to you.
You know, speaking of Booker T. Washington,
George Washington Carver. Hello?
Yeah.
And so my thing is, what happened to I know what happened, but I'm asking you. Blacks lost all sense of shame and embarrassment. The men are as bad as the women. They, like, totally believe that they can't make it. It's not in them. They think white people are superior. You hear it all the time. White supremacists, white privilege, white this. And so they feel that they totally have been convinced that they can't make it. There's something wrong with them. And so they want white people to weaken themselves so that black can feel better about being losers. I don't understand that.
You know, Booker T. Washington, he advocated that he tried to make a compromise. He advocated that blacks should just work by their hands and do the lower jobs and so forth, and not really strive to be in leadership positions or compete with white folks.
That's a lie. You just lied on Booker T. I happen to know Booker T. You just lied.
Look at the Atlanta Commission. That's what he advocated.
He wanted when the emancipation or whatever happened thing, emancipation, proclamation happened. He believed that blacks should have stayed in the South because they already knew how to work. They already knew how to farm and do all that. And rather than running up north and turning themselves over to the so-called black leaders, Emancipation Commission Proclamation. He believed that the blacks should stay in the South and just buy their own land, farm their own land, and they would have been they would be more independent, they would have been free. Instead of moving up north with those crooks like W.B. Du Bois and others who wanted to control the blacks. So you just lied on Booker T. And that speech that he gave in Atlanta, Georgia was amazing.
Let me tell you something.
You can't tell me about Booker T. I may not know my flowers, but I know Booker T.
You don't know nothing. You don't know a darn thing.
I know that Joel has on an Afro shirt today.
Booker T. Washington's notion that blacks should be limited to just working by hands and not aspiring to anything else.
He wanted them to be independent, man.
And he said they should do both. They can be independent and they can strive for higher education.
That's what it means to be independent.
And leadership. Huh?
Hey, huh? And you lied about education because if Booker T did not believe in education, he would not have invented one of the not anymore. One of the greatest universities on earth, Tuskegee Institute.
By blacks striving for
you don't know what you're talking
to
about.
Compete with them in higher education.
Earl, you don't know what you're talking about.
Read the Atlantic Commission, dumb boy that you don't know anything. You're so retarded. That's why you never graduated. That's why you laugh in your class.
Yeah,
and
number 18. There were 18 kids.
That you haven't researched. Don't know.
It was only 18 kids in my class. I was number 18.
Yeah. You're talking about number 19. The 18th was dumber than you.
I was number 18.
You.
I was the dumbest.
Yeah. But you were dumber than number 18. You were number 19. You were below.
Right. That's why you don't need a college education. See what happened to me? Earl, thank you for your call. Happy Thanksgiving.
Adios, amigos. Try to research something and learn something.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you. Enjoy yourself.
You too, buddy. I got to take a break back in a moment.
Like, my cousin, like, sent me you, and I thank him for that. It was more of a, you know, he thinks the whole, like, everything's a joke. That just adds a little spice to it. But in the heart of what you're saying, there is real things going on.
Yeah.
People want to overlook that. And I'm telling you, Mr. Peterson, I'm not one of those people. And I thank God that, you know, he showed you to me. And sometimes we just need some Jesse in our lives, I guess.
Thank you, Chris.
I wish we had more brothers like you. We need more brothers like you, just because we don't have most guys that can, you know, stand lead black people into the right direction. And I thank you for that, because a lot of people will be like, man, it's still going on. It's racism. Yeah. And I try to tell them, like, watch his show. Listen to this brother. He's telling the truth.
Take no thought about tomorrow. Yesterday doesn't exist. And you're going to see, man, God is with us and all is well. It's interesting in talking to Earl and blacks like him. They don't even want it to be said. They don't want the idea or the notion that blacks can be independent and that they too can do without begging and blaming and whining about the past and affirmative action and reparations. They don't even want to, they don't believe that blacks are capable, to the point that, you know, they don't even want you to say it. That's mind-blowing to me. It really is mind-blowing. I wouldn't want it to be said that I couldn't make it on my own. What kind of mess is that? Whether you had a so-called education or not, as long as you can work with your hands, you got to have food on your table. As long as you treat people the way you would like to be treated, you got to have friends around you, whatever it is that you want. It's mind-blowing. They don't want it to be said. Black people, not all, but most, do believe that white people are superior to them. They don't think that they are capable. And you see it in the blacks' attitude. They wear afros trying to prove that they are better than the white man. They burn down the white man businesses, destroy the white man's statues and monuments. Like, that is proving that they are stronger, but It's proven that they are still weaker. What the? They don't even want it to be said. They don't want you to encourage other blacks that you have it in you to do. You can start your own business. You don't need government. The less government, the better off you are. I didn't grow up with no government. I didn't even know you can get a government help until I moved to the city. It's mind-blowing. I'm glad I didn't know that. I'm glad my son didn't know that. And I'm glad his kids doesn't know that. Because it's in you. No one is better than you. We're all the same. We came from the same source. We're not all God's children, only those who have been born again and returned to the Father. But we all can do it if you want to. Really, it's in you. It has nothing to do with color. And Earl and people like that, there's a young man called me yesterday from Georgia, just a proud of affirmative action. Oh, we got a lot of money. And that don't make you a better person because you got money. Some of the worst persons on earth have money. Look at Obama and Big Mama Michelle and Bill Clinton and Hillary Clinton. They got money, but they're horrible people. Thanksgiving dinner is going to be interesting this year. And let me show you why. This is from Campus Reform. Students at George Mason University in Virginia talk about going home to discuss racial injustice and the Black Lives Matter movement with parents over Thanksgiving dinner. I wouldn't let my child in my house, they came talking like that. But watch this.
Are you excited to see your family?
I'm really excited. I love my family. I have a great relationship with them.
Did you say you have the same political philosophy as your family?
Not for them. My family's a little bit more conservative than I am. Do you feel like I'm more on, like, the liberal side?
And do you think this year, more than ever, it's important to bring up those hard topics at the dinner table?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I think it's important to talk about. So what issues do you think are important to talk about at the dinner table specifically?
Definitely Trump's policies on LGBTQ rights. If you're voting for somebody who's actively against my rights as a person, then where does that go hand in hand?
Both of our families are immigrants, so like we care a lot about immigrant issues as well.
Trump saying that it was a rigged election.
Issues like climate change are really important. You know, women's rights and BLM, of course.
Definitely the racial discrimination.
Black history, it sounds kind of bad, but like my parents didn't have such a high education, neither did the majority of my family, so I want to make sure they understand history and like are educated about that side of things.
The Black Lives Matter movement, probably white supremacy, things like that should definitely be talked about.
Amazing. I wouldn't let them come. I'm like, y'all stay away. If I made a turkey plate for them, I'd take it back the moment they brought that up. And they don't have boys in college anymore. It was all girls. No boys there anymore? What the? All girls. And it's easy to brainwash girls, females. All girls. And they just a dumb as a doorknob. And the parents are paying their kids to be brainwashed, paying the schools to brainwash their children. Buku money. They get what they deserve. They should come home talking about Black Lives Matter. You paying for it. Amazing. Democrat U.S. Senator Cory Booker, a loser, right? And Elizabeth Warren, and others will be formally introducing the Justice for Black Farmers Act on November 30th. They're in the Senate, right? And they're going to be introducing something called the Justice for Black Farmers Act on November 30th. BookerSenate.gov says that the Justice for Black Farmers Act charges America with the sin of institutional racism and aim to set up the Equitable Land Asset Service, which would purchase millions of acres of private land and redistribute them to eligible Black individuals. So to break it down in Black terms, they're going to take your tax dollars, so-called purchase land, and give it to other Black people. They're going to take your land, and there's nothing to stop them. Nothing. White people are not going to speak up about it for fear of being called racist. You're having South Africa come to the forefront now in America. They're going to take your land, white folks. They're destroying the police department so you're not protected. They're getting rid of the Second Amendment so you can't protect yourself in your own home, and they're coming after you. You've been warned. Either you stand up and vote these people out, or you suffer and die. It's up to you. You grown. If you don't want to protect yourself, your land, your country, it's totally up to you. But they're going to take your land. And who are the eligible Black individuals? How would you know who they are? Eligible for what? To get free land? The slaves are all dead. And the slaves were not even complaining about land. They bought it when they wanted it. You've been lied to. And now look, they're brainwashing the children at George Mason University. They go home to have turkey while going off on their parents because their parents are conservatives. Your child left home as a conservative and returned home as a child of Satan, brainwashed. And you paid buku money for it, hundreds and thousands of dollars, to brainwash your own children. You sold them over to the devil, or you paid the devil to take them over, take over their minds. Only in America, socialism at its finest. You're right, Joel. And everybody just kind of sit back. I don't know what you're waiting for. This country is in a state of emergency. Your house is burning down. Amazing. Nate is out of Pennsylvania. Hey, Nate, welcome to the show. You're on the air.
Hey, Jesse, great show today.
Thank you, man.
Yeah, they are coming for the land, though.
The Equitable Land Asset Service will be introduced to the Senate, and it will pass. There's nothing to stop it.
Yeah, and I mean, the first good move on their part is to come for guns at any point, way you can, you know?
Yeah, they're going after the Second Amendment. In Pennsylvania, you can't even apply for a gun now. They've shut down the area, the place where you go to get a permit to buy a weapon.
Yeah.
The Democrats are serious about taking over the people.
Yeah, I got mine right before that here in Pennsylvania. But
good, man. And when Black Lives Matter start burning down the country, or the blacks start robbing and stealing and destroying and taking and slapping, knocking out white people, they bought guns like 90 going north, long lines for people. And now the Democrats have said, oh, no, we can't let that happen. We cannot allow white people to protect themselves.
Yeah, and once again, it's a double standard that doesn't make any sense. Like, if we believe them with Black Lives Matter, then the establishment is super racist and black people are targeted by cops and the cops are evil. Well, if we believe that, why do we want to ban guns from everybody but the cop? Like if we believe that black people are being targeted, then shouldn't the Second Amendment stay so that black people can have all these guns to defend themselves?
It's amazing. It's crazy. But we have two things happening in the world today, good and evil. And these people are evil, but the good folks won't stand up. So I got to ask you, who is the Christian's worst enemy?
I believe it's the Christians themselves, other Christians. I think that they end up setting each other back by focusing on things that aren't necessarily as important. Like, I think there's, like, minutia that they can debate about later, but I just don't think we're at that point yet. Like, and I think it ends up hurting the cause. For example, the one question I had a while back was having sex while you're married but not for procreation. And I think that getting divisive on that and, like, kind of, I don't want to use the word nitpicking, but I don't have a great vocabulary on that, might be separating more than we want to. Like, I think right now is, like, the time to be united, and the little things might fracture us when we need that uniting, but I might be wrong.
So you think that the Christian, when I ask who is the Christian's worst enemy, and you're saying that they are their own worst enemy?
Yeah, because their enemies are always going to be tearing them down. And so if they're tearing each other down, then that's a bigger problem than what they're used to, which is non-Christians tearing them down.
Amazing. I'm going to put my two cents in on Sunday. I appreciate it, Nate. Thank you for responding. I want to hear from you. Who is the Christian's worst enemy? It's an amazing question. Absolutely amazing. Vinny is out of Brooklyn, New York. Let's see here. Oh. Ooh. Vinny, I hit the wrong knob. I mean, button. I hit. I'm sorry, man. Call back and try to get in. I hope you can. Joshua is a first-time caller out of Los Angeles. Sorry, Vinny. Oh, amazing. Joshua, welcome to the show. You're on the air.
Hey, nice to meet you. I wanted to ask a question. I remember when you talk about returning to the father and forgiving the mother, one of my aspects is I lost my mom in a couple of years back.
Right.
And I've gone through a lot of things as of late. From, well, one, living with my brother, but then things turned south.
How old are you, Joshua?
24.
Okay, go ahead.
When things went south, I'm sorry. Sorry if I speak a little cryptically, because I still have an aspect of I just don't want my brother to know where I am, you know?
You hide it from your brother?
Well, it's not exactly. Okay, I'm not going to just try to say not exactly, but it's more like this. I want to meet my brother again on my own terms.
Okay.
I just don't want, because after all that I've gone through, the best way to find it is this. I never got to make choices on my own. Simply put.
Is he older than you?
Yeah. Well, he's my half-brother.
Okay. Is he, are you afraid of him?
Well, I'm going to say when I was younger, he actually tried to come at me when our own mother had to stand in between us.
And so are you
disrespecting my mom?
Are you angry at him?
You could say, I'll say yes. I'm not going to hide from this.
Were you a mama's boy?
Yeah, I'll say yes, because all I had was my mom and brother growing up.
And mom, where was your father?
Not in the picture. Factors, I was told one story about how my dad tried to put her on drugs.
Put your mama on drugs?
But another factor is I have been speaking to my dad, and he told me he would never do anything of the sort.
Did your mother tell you that your father tried to put her on drugs?
Yes.
Why did she tell you that?
Actually, I don't know. All I knew, I always wondered where my father was in the picture. And the only time I ever had contact with him, I'm just getting to this, was a long time ago at Stater Brothers. Our cars crash, and I didn't know who this man was with clubbed fingers. But my mom's talking to him about me, other stuff, life. Then when I'm just sitting outside at the Stater Brothers back from where I'm from, I tried to share my lunch bowl with a coworker outside.
So let me ask, how old were you when your mother told you your father tried to put her on drugs?
We'll assume somewhere around the 9 to 10 range. I'm not sure.
Why did she tell you something like that?
Well, because not connected. All I knew at the time, factors on both my dad and my brother's, was that, my brother's dad beat her,
And you my father. Her.
Do you know that your mother was evil for telling you that?
After listening to a lot of your stuff over time, I'm kind of noticing that.
Yeah, realize I want you to do what you want, but realize she was evil, she was wrong, but she couldn't help it. And so you can forgive her, you can stop hating her for that, and your life would change.
I'm just wondering, do I just say I forgive, or do I go? Because she's gone.
Right, but just realize she couldn't help it. She was crazy.
I'm not trying to disrespect my mom, but I'll say that is definitely an understatement.
It's not disrespectful to know that your mother is crazy.
Yeah, it just comes with the fact when I had lost my mom, it was one of the worst days of my life.
Why?
I didn't know what to do at the time. She was already suffering from select diseases, but the day when it all happened, they already ended up doing a lot of medical stuff to her.
I know, but your mother sounded like she was an evil woman. Why aren't you glad she's gone?
Just because when I was growing up, I felt like she was the only person who ever gave a damn about me.
She didn't care about you. If your mother had loved you, she would have never turned you away from your father. She would have never made you believe that she was a victim and your father was somehow or another this bad guy. Your mother did not love you. She had no love.
Just thinking about it all now, it explains a lot.
And
when I was living with my brother, I'm just going to say it now, my brother was mentally abusive, because it literally has to take the fact that in my own mother's will, she had to say, don't pick on your brother, among other things. Don't get me wrong, my brother did the best he could. I'm not trying to just demonize him, you understand?
But look what type of mother you had. No wonder your brother was mean too. He had the same mother you had.
And an aspect I notice is, even though he's a grown man, I'm going to say it now, I still saw a child.
Right. Stop hating him. He couldn't help it. You guys had You guys had the same mother. He could not help it. And if he's mean to you, I would stay away from him, but don't be mad at him so that you can have a free life. You can live your life. Your brother cannot help himself.
I wanted to say this because it was in 2016 when it happened. Everything was falling apart. I tried my best at other things. Don't get me wrong. I take responsibility when I made my mistakes, because the aspect of being a man is having accountability. But I knew that if I ended up going with him, I say it now, I would have committed suicide.
Right. Well, be glad that you didn't. Stop being angry. Are you close to your father now?
Actually, I have been talking with my father.
Nice.
And he is a pastor, and things he's told me is that because of his genes, I do have a very forgiving spirit.
Well, forgive your mother and your father, meaning stop hating them, stop hating your brother, and you'll be fine, but you got to drop the anger, all right?
Yeah, I just...
How old are you, Joshua?
24.
Okay.
The point is, when I began to hear a lot of your podcasts, it was an aspect of basically understanding one of the things I've been missing. And the best way I put it is very simple. I didn't get to have a proper father figure role model in my life.
Yeah.
And there was always an empty void.
Yep. Absolutely.
And understanding that, it's an aspect that also interplayed with, well, my aspect of not being able to make a choice for myself. Everything was being made for me, and I'm not being able to define myself as once a boy, but now a man.
Repeat that.
This is just a fact. This is an aspect that fell into play, which was by me not being able to make choices. It was a factor that, sorry, I kind of lost my train of thought there. But the point is, I didn't get to make choices growing up, not being able to define myself as once a boy, but now a man. And my goal is very simple. I have dreams on my heart for what I want to create in the world, but I moreover want to be a good man, a man of God in mind, body, and spirit.
Joshua, here's what you do. You I want you to do my silent prayer that video.
I have looked up your silent prayer.
Forgive your
and
brother.
And I remember the first time I did it, it was weird. I noticed some colors. I didn't know what was going on.
Well, just watch it. Just observe, and you'll be fine. But drop the anger for your father, your mother, and your brother, and yourself. And God will develop the real you into a man. You will naturally become a man and a man of God. But you got to let... And I'm glad you don't have the anger. Stay away from your brother.
Yeah.
Your brother can help it.
Yeah. What I was trying to say was, as time has gone on from that point all those years ago to where I'm at now,
yeah,
I say that God has given me a lot of insight when I look at all the situation, because I've gotten two sides of the spectrum,
yeah,
knowing my mom both in life and in death, but yeah, also understanding my brother and his actions,
yeah,
when it came to speaking to select people.
That's
it's
right.
For the fact that the people that God puts in your life for only a certain period of time, whether it be good or bad, they're meant to be lessons. Teach you what
that's
you want
right.
in your
so
life.
Relax, man, and let your life unfold. Call me again, and happy Thanksgiving to you, all right? Thank you all. I absolutely appreciate it. Don't forget, for special shout outs, go to Cameo, CAMEO.com. And happy Thanksgiving to all of you. We will be here tomorrow if the Lord is willing and the creek don't rise. Hake is coming up at 9 a.m. after I'm done here with the Hake Report. .com. You don't want to miss it. And by the way, thank you for supporting Bond, my nonprofit, at rebuildingaman.com, the church service, and all of that. I don't take it for granted. Derek is a first-time caller out of Virginia. Ron is out of Atlanta, Georgia. Thomas is out of Canada. And whomever calling it, I cannot get to you. I cannot get to you, but I will be back tomorrow live, if the Lord is willing and the creek don't rise. I asked the producer, hey, are we doing a live show tomorrow? He's like, yeah, what the? So we will be here live, as well as the Hate Report. He will be live tomorrow, too. Happy Thanksgiving to you folks. And be careful on the road, those who are traveling. All right? Thank you for an amazing show today. It was an amazing, amazing package today, too. Thank you, Nick. The Acre Baby. Have a good one, folks. Face the truth about yourself and just first God's kingdom comes. Live the life that we all desire. Serve the God that we all admire. Stand up and be true. I know we can be perfect just like you. I know we can find a way to man up and stand up. It's right if we give our plans up. I know we can have faith in the unseen while we stand up and get back to the way we were designed to be.
Track one time. Joel Friday here. Check. Look, stand up, stand up. We got fighting to do. We gotta show 'em who boss. He put a Viking in you. He put that lightning in you, igniting the truth. But you beg and blame and lie and hate and never wanna stand for the truth. So what you planning to do? You understand in the loop? You better go talk to your mama. Better stop all the drama. Better drop all the trauma. Boy, you better stand up and up. Put your hand up and hut, huh? Cause if you don't, then we lose, and then we gotta hear the fake news. Whoa.